I'm Mr. Red. A horse is a horse, of course, of course. And no one can talk to a horse, of course. That is, of course, unless the horse is the famous Mr. Red. Go right to the source and ask the horse. He'll give you the answer that you endorse. He's always on a steady course. Talk to Mr. Red.
Six, ten. It. Strange. Take off your coat. Are you wearing cologne?
Nope. Not wearing anything. Should I be?
No. Smells like something I wore a long time ago. Well, I'm making some tea for the meeting. Would you like some?
No, I thought you liked green tea better.
I do.
Hey, is it Tori?
Hi.
Evening, Mr. Greentree.
Uh-huh.
Oh, thank you very much.
Six, ten.
Oof, cold in here.
Yeah, it's feeling colder in here than it does outside.
The song. I haven't heard this song in 57 years. I don't own this song. This song is not on the record.
Elmer, what song?
There is no sound coming out of this record player.
In the air, Corporal. The 57th is en route to participate in a mission. Target longitude, 5 degrees, 13 minutes, 34 seconds east. Latitude, 53 degrees, 28 minutes, 21 seconds north.
Krefeld, nickel raid on the steel yards.
That information is not for you to know.
But I do.
We've got 262 Lancaster bombers in the air. Gonna be a lot of boys needing to help home making it to the other side.
You act like you're alone, Greentree. We have others working like you. Good luck.
After a bomber crew had gone for a burden, I would help them find their way safely to the other side.
Wait, they'd go where?
For a burden. A beer. Gone for a burden meant they died. The British airman's equivalent of buying the farm. Bomber crews in the Second World War had a 1 in 5 chance of being killed on a sortie. And they were required to fly 30 missions, so it was all but mathematically impossible to survive.
Then you would have guided thousands to the other side.
So the presence you felt here tonight could be one of thousands?
No. Could be only one.
Damn it.
Probably Marion calling to say she can't make it.
Hey, sweetie.
No, sorry, you got the wrong number.
Who did they want?
It was the wrong number.
I heard that. Who did they ask for?
They were looking for a Mr. Carlisle.
Meeting's over.
We haven't even started, Elmer. Marion and Albert and Warren haven't even gotten here yet.
They'll have to go, too. Come on.
You all right?
I'm fine.
Does this have to do with the presence you felt earlier? Can't we help somehow?
We can help by leaving. I don't mean to be rude. I feel fine. I just need to be alone right now.
You will tell us what this is about later.
No, I'll probably never be able to tell you.
All right.
You will.
Good night,
Elmer.
Looking for Mr. Carlisle. He's ordered from our fall collection.
Come in. I see you're not alone this time, Colonel Montgomery.
Elmer Greentree, this is Mr. Glick.
I'm aware of your history.
I guess if you're here, there's no need to waste time in introductions.
Elmer, we have a pilot down. Lieutenant Daniel K. Maxwell. The situation is intensely critical. SNR teams have been deployed. Is he alive? And if so, where?
They're telling me, Iraq no-fly zone.
That information is not for you to know.
But I do.
How? How did you know that?
I've got friends in high places.
Yes, Mr. Greentree. He is down there, somewhere. And we know they know he's there. I'm hoping you can help us find him first.
I'll do everything within my power to help that boy, Colonel. Would you get the light for me, please, Colonel?
Anything we should know?
Someone's trying to get my attention.
Someone? Can't your friends in high places tell you who it is?
They know that I won't bother with anyone until we get this pilot home safely.
Your last known position was 31 degrees, 10 minutes, 4 seconds south, 42 degrees, 14 minutes, 7 seconds east.
Sky. Stars. There's land below. Dark. Hard to see. Hard to see. But it's barren. Desert. Angels 13-2 on my 4 o'clock. Sam's up. Jingle left. Cold. 10 below 0 at least.
Did he bail out?
No. He's in the plane. Large, clear bubble beneath him. Skin of the plane is rattling, buckling. I've seen this before. After all this time, why now? You more than anyone should want me to help this boy. Oh, you didn't follow me. You didn't follow me! Thank you.
Scared the hell out of me.
So sorry. Wasn't my intention, mate.
Damn.
They serve better liquor in the officers' club.
Right.
What? They'll allow Yanks.
They're not colored Yanks. Or colored music.
I've heard this song in the officers' club.
No. You heard the song Spinner's version. This here is the Four Vagabonds. This has more soul. Listen.
By soul, you mean?
Heart, man. Spirit.
Right, right, spirit. That's the motto of my squadron. Corpus non anima muto. My body may change, but not my spirit. You know plenty about music?
Yeah. I wanted to be a musician.
But?
I know more about spirit. What squadron you flying with? Okay, okay. You know for damn sure I ain't no crowd.
I'm an air gunner with the 57th. 10-hour missions. Some Nazi gets 10 below up there. Yeah. Lank bomber, number ED610. Andrew Church. My nickname is Vicar.
Elmer Greentree.
Who are you with, Elmer?
Myself, I guess. I'm on loan to the RAF.
What do you do?
I hope you never have to find that out, Vicar. Yeah, yeah, right here, see?
Right, this does have spirit.
So.
Strange how a song can capture how one feels.
So.
No. No. It's not how I feel. I cannot wait. If I wait any longer, I'll die. I can't wait another day. It's impossible. She's in the Women's Auxiliary Air Force. Aircraftswoman, second class, Amy Alexander. She's my soulmate, Elmer. And I can't wait till then.
Tell me about her.
Oh, Elmer, she's the most beautiful thing you ever seen.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Let's dream of what there will be till then. We'll call on each family till then. When I will hold you again, please wait till.
Now you know what I do. Gentlemen, there's no need to be afraid. I'm here to help you home. Vicar, no. Andrew, no. Come with me. Come with me.
Every minute that goes by places Lieutenant Maxwell in greater danger.
I've been through this with you before.
Many times. Always effective.
There's a spirit on the other side. It doesn't understand. It's blocking my ability to reach this boy. Now, if I could find out what it wants, if I could make it understand what
we
it
have
wants.
A pilot down in the desert, open, exposed, enemy territory. It's 8:30 here, 4:30 a.m. in Iraq. At the moment, it's dark. In 60 minutes, however, the sun will rise. We don't have time for an exorcism.
I think it's best we go. Thank you for your time, Mr. Greentree.
No, wait. I've only failed at this once before. Now, 57 years later, it's back to haunt me. I can't have it happen again.
My God, what happened? Suddenly it's 10 below in here.
Stop it! It's not my fault! You didn't follow me, Vicar. You didn't follow me. So go on. Go on to the other side. Stop it! Young man's gonna die because of you, Vicar. I won't help you. You can stay where you are forever. I won't help you move on if you don't let me find him.
Hi. Sorry I'm late. But I was studying at a friend's dorm.
What's your friend's name?
Ed.
And his dorm room number is 610.
Well, yeah. I guess by now I should know how you know that, but is there a problem with that?
It's 610. You were made to be late for a reason. Come with me. You've got a lifetime of learning to do in less than 60 minutes. Nothing ever dies. Now, that's not about the paranormal or the supernatural, Marion. In fact, it's just natural. Nothing ever dies. One time, before there was time, everything was together. You, me, this table, the earth, the moon, stars. Everything was together in a form the size of my fist. It ignited. But none of us went our separate ways. Stars were formed. You and I made up those stars. When their fuel was spent, we didn't die. We were sent out to take on another form. You want to see the past? You want to know the future? Look in the mirror. It's there. You understand this? Then knowing, understanding that there is no division, no real boundaries, that there is no separation between anything, it just is, allows you to shift your sense of perception.
I don't understand how.
You have the ability, Marion. You see, you've already done this once before, accidentally, with Albert. The hardest part for you is not the ability, it's the frame of mind. Moving up from, I believe this is true, to I know this is true.
How?
Just remember, there's no separation between you, the envelope, the picture inside it, and what the picture's of. It's all the same. Know it. All right, close your eyes. Take rhythmic breaths, meditative breaths. Don't try to guess what's inside it. You're not a magician. It's not a parlor game. You are what's inside, and it is you. Go further. Good. Don't be alarmed by the sensation. Go further.
I see small circles, hundreds.
Circles are you, Marion.
And a cloud of black, eight lines.
The cloud is you. You're the lines. No, it is true.
I'm an octopus.
There's no difference in doing this than what you just did with that envelope. It may take longer, but there is no difference. If you even think there is, then you'll fail. But I know you won't.
Wait. Can't you at least guide me through this?
Until I guide another to the other side, I can't help you with it. Marion, you'll be fine. You don't know how talented you are. Now, I'll be working in the next room. When you find a target, you'll know. You get me immediately. Talking to the spirit that was known on this side as Andrew Church. Vicar, if you're here, raise the center plane. I'm calling here. Spirit known on this side as Andrew Church. Vicar, I take it you are here now. Time is different where you are now. 57 years have passed since your body died. You need to move on to the other side. Find peace there. Go to the other side. Vicar, why are you so angry? You didn't follow me that night. You were the one who chose not to go to the other side. Why don't you respond? Is there another spirit with you? Is there another form in this room?
I'm talking to this presence. Identify yourself to me. Show me who you are.
Even the great Elmer Greentree never knew it was possible. You have prevented yourself from finding that downed pilot. Time never passes, but it also never stands still. Now, I'm here because I'm forever at a critical moment in our life to save two souls from an eternal passing.
He's alive.
Now, how do you know these things are not me? I didn't know this back then.
That's right, but that's wrong. There's no one left to teach you here. When you move to the other side, there'll be a lot for you to learn. But here, on this side, I've appeared to help you guide yourself.
Why at that time in my life?
There are people and events, regrets in our life, old man, that you have the ability to rectify. That you must do when you move on to that side, which will be soon.
Elmer?
Why this urgency after half a century?
On this side, lives are saved. On the other side, souls are saved.
I found him. He's alive. Elmer, but he's in trouble. They found him.
Do you remember the night he went down? What Andrew said?
Come with me. Come with me.
I'll wait for her.
Yes, but you have to wait for her on the other side. The others in the plane can't wait. Your crewmen can't wait. I have to guide them now, or they'll never make it. Don't do this to them. Don't do it to yourself. Come with me. You can't be with her on this side.
And we let him go. He never crossed over. Andrew remains on that plane where he can't be found, waiting. Of all those men, he's the one we failed to help. She was heartbroken. Like millions of people then, the war kept him from ever sharing a life. And in his honor and spirit, she vowed never to marry anyone else.
Who needs to know this?
The spirit wants to be healed by time. And Amy Alexander let it happen. She married, children, grandchildren. A long and good life with Andrew barely more than a memory. Something that happened another lifetime ago. And that, old man, is why now, why I couldn't wait any longer. Amy Alexander's about to die and cross over to the other side. But when she does, Andrew, closer to this side than the other, will be there first and keep her with him. As a new spirit, she won't understand and believe she should remain with him. Neither will ever fully cross over to the other side. Their spirits will be lost forever.
How do I find who needs to know this?
It's time.
I'm a friend of Elmer Greentree's.
I don't know who that is.
I know where Lieutenant Maxwell is. And so do they.
Turn it around.
Amy!
Andrew Church?
I said I'd wait till then.
This is just a dream.
No. You've passed on. We're together again. Forever.
Not here. Don't be afraid. There's no reason to be afraid here. I'm here to guide you.
No. No, who are you?
We met right over there, listening to the Mills Brothers, 57 years ago. Now, since you will only see Amy as the way you want to see her, I'm here to show you that life went on. I guess I should say I'm sorry for having gone on with my life. I had to. We all had to. Amy had to. You should have that night. I'm here to finish what I should have, what you should have done that night.
I won't go. I won't lose her again.
You won't lose each other? Not if you follow. You'll be together on the other side properly. That's where she's going, Victor. That's where she belongs. Where you belong.
My life was wasted. Stolen from me.
Wasn't wasted. You gave your life for her, for me. Millions did. I'll never be forgotten. You were robbed of a life. Just one. Just this one. Don't rob yourself or Amy of the chance at others.
You'll never have to look back on Andrew with regret.
Yeah, but I still lived over half my life with the pain of that regret.
You could have carried that for eternity. Go back, old man. I'll guide them now. Make certain that we get there.
I was a good-looking man.
We got him.
All of us involved cannot thank you enough, Miss Kidd. Now, you must know, Marion, realize this never occurred. You can never discuss this with anyone. You must never make contact with Lieutenant Maxwell.
I understand.
You said he wasn't here.
I'm talking to Andrew and Amy. When the flames burn out, you'll be on the other side. And Corporal, you will return. And be safe.
Although there are oceans we must cross, and mountains that we must climb, I know every gate must have a lord. So pray that a lord is nothing but time. Till then, let's dream of what there will be. Till then, we'll call on each memory. Till then, when I will hold you again, please wait till then. Although there are oceans we must cross and mountains that we must climb, I know every game must have a loss. So pray that our loss is nothing but time. Till then, let's dream of what there will be. Till then, we'll call on each memory. Till then.